Ruslan.
Kanye's been wilding lately, by the way. I had a comment I left on his Instagram when he dropped this artwork for this song, and the comment went viral and got like 4,000 likes and a bunch of people arguing. And Kanye's been on one, man. I feel bad for him because I think, unfortunately, this is what happens when you have an encounter with God and then you just wild out and go do what you want. Right? The Jesus is King. He has the choir. I believe that he had a real encounter with Jesus. And then if you had a real encounter with Jesus and you live your life whatever way you want to live your life, that comes with consequences and that comes with serious repercussions. It's like God won't allow you to enjoy your sin the same way post Christ. I'm not sure if that makes sense, right? So like you can go and fornicate and you can go and do all these other things, but it's not going to be the same. So it's not going to be the same joys it was when you were spiritually dead. And I think what you're seeing with Kanye, this man apparently, allegedly, on front page of TMZ, knocked out a random fan in the middle of the night in downtown LA, arguing with, I think, his cousin. You're seeing, you know, him with potentially, allegedly multiple women. And you're seeing all these different things and you're seeing him unravel publicly. And remember, like, this is a 45-year-old dad, okay, with like multiple little kids, and he's in a studio with like Madonna and Game. Like the dude is going through it, and I don't think this ends well. The new song came out. I'll just read his parts. I am not a fan of the Game. I think the Game is super problematic. It looks like Kanye's back to cussing. They can't compare us-ish. I'm rapping on some Paris-ish. I'm talking mama's house, crying on your brother's shoulders. Get the question mark out. God save me from that crash. Just so I can beat Pete Davidson's. That's it? That's all he said on her whole record? Yeah, and I think the situation with Kim is a mess. It's like they're like high school children, like trying to make each other jealous. So here's my thought. Like this is when it goes into once saved, always saved. Is can someone be saved and struggle with sin and addiction? This is how I would define it. In my life, and I'm sure in your life, you've probably gone through spells where you were born again, yet you were wilding out. Okay, and I would hate for me or you at our lowest point to be smothered with cameras and to have paparazzi pull up on you and to do all of, you know, all of those different things, right? So I think there's one side of this where there has to be some grace and mercy extended. The other side of this is there has to be a firmness from the folks around him who love Jesus, the folks around him who follow him on social media. He follows me on Instagram, that when he posts something out of pocket, when he does something out of pocket, the church doesn't just look away. Right? Like you're going to be, even if it's through a comment on Instagram, I'm going to be like, bro, this ain't it. Like you need to repent. You need to do a 180. You need to turn around. So that's the tension that we live in, right? Because you don't just do whatever you want to do as a born again Christian, especially when you've, you know, identified as a man of God and all these different things. From the other side, it's like, fam, he's probably going through the worst year of his life since his mom passed. We judge others' salvation from their works or fruits, but what measuring stick are we using? So here's the thing, John. I think when it says fruits, I don't think that's saying that if someone is going through a rough year or a rough week or a rough day and they're sinning, I don't think that's talking about that sort of fruit. When he says you'll know them by their fruit, I think that's more aligned. What is their faith system? What is their belief system? Right? Are they professing Jesus? Are they following Jesus? So on and so forth. So I think there's a disconnect when we say that, because what that really sounds like is if you don't keep behaving the way I want you to behave or the way Christians should behave, then you're not saved. And I don't think that's what the gospel teaches. I think the gospel teaches you're saved by grace through faith. Grace. Faith. Jesus redeemed us. Jesus bought us back. Even the narcissist, even the mega famous person, even the person that's addicted to sex, even the person that's addicted to fill in the blank, Jesus bought us back. That is what the gospel is. Okay? You could not earn your way into heaven. You got redeemed and bought back because of the work of Jesus on the cross. And it is not by works that you're saved. It is by grace through faith, so that no man should boast. Now, discipleship, living a holy life, abiding in the faith, that requires that requires dying to yourself. That requires following Jesus daily. That requires killing your sin, right? All of these other things. So examine your own life, like genuinely examine your own life. Has there ever been a time, and it probably was, probably within the last month, maybe the last year, where you've been doing out-of-pocket things, knowing that this was dishonoring to God, but you did it anyway? Does that mean you weren't saved? No. Okay? That means you were wild. Now, if you stay in that state, and there's no conscience, there's no, they're like, you're just like, I'm basking. If you, now, then you got to say, wait, am I actually saved or not, right? So, in the case of Ye, I don't know where and why he's in this place. I do believe from my personal experience and from attending a couple Sunday service events to knowing some of the pastors he's had around him, from all spectrums of the theological spectrum, from Pastor Adam Tyson. So it's a wide spectrum. Rich Wilkinson, folks from every camp have been around him. He's given them his platform, so on and so forth. I think if I'm looking at it from that regard, I think Kanye is somebody that had a born-again experience. This is my opinion, by the way. He's had a born-again experience, and he's going through the worst year of his life. He's in the middle of a messy divorce. His wife is dating the dude that he, you know, spent last Thanksgiving with. Like, it's all a mess. It's all a mess. So I think the answer to what do I think of Kanye is, man, let's be praying for that brother. Just like you keep praying for the brother in your church that can't stop sleeping with his girlfriend, that can't stop, you know, smoking cigarettes, that can't stop, right? Like, you, it's the same thing, you know? I think Kanye's self-aware enough to know that he's jacked up. Like, he's a mess. I think he knows that, and I think he knows the grace of God covers that. I don't know if he knows how to get out of this roller coaster of a life that he has. And when you go back and you think of when he was in a healthy place with Jesus, he was actually not in the media. He was tucked away on a ranch, you know what I'm saying? Like, people had to come to him. Now he's in the mix. Now he's moving around. And so I think so much of this is so obvious. Like, you want to act like you're superhero Christian and judge this man, but like, if we were to really put your life under a microscope and put cameras when you're at your worst, what would that look like? You know? And so, again, grace and truth. We got to be full of grace and truth. The grace side says, man, Kanye didn't do anything to deserve his salvation anyway. And I believe God's going to finish what he started, right? The truth side of that is, bruh, you're out of pocket. You got to chill. You know what I'm saying? And so when I see this wild game cover, I'm going to say something. You know what I mean? And I don't know if he's going to see this or not, but maybe he will. You know, and maybe he'll see your comment. Who knows? Like, who knows? But I think dismissing and discarding something, this is where people were like, yo, the world kind of learned cancel culture from the church. Like, we were the first to cancel people. We were the first to discard people. We were the, when someone hits rock bottom and is going through it, they're out. You know, when it really, to my opinion, I'm thinking like, yo, all these pastors, right? Like, can they get a hold of him right now? Can they pull up on him? When he was going through it on the ranch with, that he was having an episode, a guy like Dave, who's not even a Christian, Dave Chappelle pulled up on him. This man pulled up on him. Hey, I was worried about you. Remember there was that awkward clip where Dave Chappelle pulled up and Kanye's like, say something funny, Dave, say something funny. And Dave was like, you know, like, my question would be like, yo, these pastors that got his ear, Pastor Rich Wilkinson, who married him and Kim, right? Mike Todd was at the Sunday service that I was at. Okay, this is not an endorsement of everything these guys believe, so please miss me with that. Right? Pastor Adam Tyson, who's like 1,000-point reformed guy, went to John MacArthur's church, right? This is a wide spectrum of people here, if we're going to be honest. If I'm one of those guys, like, I'm pulling up on Kanye. Like, I'm pulling up on Kanye. What's going on? Like, you got to get it. You got to get it together. That's neither here nor there. My guess would probably be, that's just not a dude that you can, like, just get a hold of whenever you feel like it, especially if he's not wanting to be dealt, messed with. Like, he probably just, I want to be left alone. Leave me alone. Grace and truth. You know, don't say this is just in the name of art. Don't do that. Because I saw a lot of Christians in the comments. This is cool art, bro. Survive. No, fam. No. This is a 45-year-old dad. He got kids. And his kids are old enough to see this stuff. And they're old enough to understand. Remember, it was North that told him no cussing on Donda. It sucks, man. He's unraveling in front of the world, and it's trash. But my heart would be like, yo, all these brothers that like you had around you, let them get a hold of you and sit down with you, you know? And this is going to sound wild. This is going to sound wild. Like, I think at that level, like, last time he came apart like this, like he had to check himself in an inpatient. And I'm more like, gosh, is that where this is going? Cause y'all remember when he was on the Pablo tour, like he had to go and sit, right? Like he had to go into a hospital for like weeks. I don't know how this gets resolved without something like that. Without him going to some sort of like some sort of mental health resource, something. He needs therapy. He absolutely needs therapy. He might need some medication. He might need some good friends. He might need to sleep. I know for a fact from my friends that he don't sleep like that, which again, if you factor in the manic episodes, when someone's manic, they don't sleep, which is dangerous. So now you're up for a week. Yeah, I don't know. It's because rock bottom is trash, fam. You know? Like, rock bottom is terrible. Yeah, so Crispy said, have faith in the Lord, all things work together for his glory. Amen. Amen. And I am curious what this looks like on the other side of this.
Kingstream Entertainment. Ruslan.
My time, my mind. What am I? What could be? Mortify. What could be? Fortify, certify, chrome man, total line, no man. Who am I? Sort of guy, borderline, no man. Hit the bag, gotta throw hands. Get the pack on my old friends. All my day ones still here, and I ain't got time to hold hands.